this is our last video of the day, for me at least. So I'm finishing up my triple today with a body sculpting class. So before I get started, I will make my standard disclaimer that I don't own rights to the music. Our playlist today is all Lady Gaga. So, hi Gaga, you own the rights to everything. Not here to make money off of you. You will need lots of stuff today. You'll need weights. You will need two sets, medium and heavy, if you have them. One set works just as well. You use what you have on hand. Gliders. Seriously. Oh, I'm sleepy. If you don't have gliders, you can use, if you're on a flat surface with the ability to slide, you can use any kind of towel. I can show you a quick demonstration. So if I say we're doing, I think, what are we doing with gliders today? Like a side lunge. So you can bring it out, okay, instead of a glider. If you are on a padded surface, you may not be able to use anything. You can just do the move without the glider. And if you are on carpet, you could use a paper plate or a plastic bag possibly. You just have to be careful with it. But that should be able to give you enough move, enough leeway there with that. So I think the paper plates would probably be the best option. Again, if you don't have anything at all, we'll just do it without the glider. It's perfectly fine. We'll still get you working. So, and a mat. You'll need a mat at the end of some things. The gliders we won't use until the very end. There are 10 exercises. 30. Yeah, I think we're going to do this just once. We'll go through everything. It's a full minute with the 10 second recovery time in between. So it's a lot of upper body work, a lot of lower body work, a lot of combo moves, and not a lot of abs in this one. We do some abs at the end of each section. So I'm going to move this up just a little bit so I have a little bit more room here. And there's cardio in between. So we will get started. I'll get the music on. Now I should probably make sure, plug this in and make sure I have enough juice on my Bluetooth here on the speaker. Pardon me for not being set up.
Power on.
Bluetooth connected.
Bluetooth pairing.
Come on, pair it up.
Bluetooth connected.
All right. Let's get started with some Gaga. All right, let's just get warmed up here. Let's roll those hips. So there isn't too much cardio in this. If you are new to my videos and my YouTube channel or follow me on Facebook or wherever you are, this will be a good class to start with if you are not a fan of cardio. I throw in cardio burst in the middle of each of these series of exercises, so you need to get your heart rate up a bit, stretch it out, and the other side, and down the middle. Just hold here and then offer a little movement, pedaling it out. Let's roll it up, roll those shoulders forward. Let's just stretch it out to each side, getting that twist in your midsection. I do a lot. You hear me say obliques a lot. I do so much oblique work. Let's stretch it over, head. So this is always a nice warm up for what you have coming. Now out front. All right, let's take it into a little jog. Nothing crazy. You can do a boxer shuffle as well. Just getting it moving, get the blood flowing. I'm going to take it into some jumping jacks. Regular jumping jacks are coming in 3, 2, 1. You don't have to jack. You can be right here. Like I said, there's not a lot of cardio in this, but we just want to get our bodies warmed up for all of the muscles we'll be working in a bit. All right, let's slow it down to a squat. We're not doing a hop hop squat, we're just squatting. Like I said, not a lot of cardio today. I did two cardio classes before this. Give me two more. Take it back to your little shuffle. Our next set of jacks, we're going to do a regular jack, and then our arms will come forward. So if you are not jacking, and you're just doing the movement, you'll be here and forward, and here and forward. For the rest of us, let's go here. Get those arms straight. Touch those fingertips at the top. You should be on your toes. All right, give me two more, and then we're gonna take it into curtsies. Curtsy it out. So this is designed to really fatigue your muscles today. It's a full minute for each move with a 10 second recovery. So take your time with it, shake it out. Make sure that your form is correct. You're taking on any modifications needed, but you're fatiguing the muscle. It's supposed to get super sore as you're going along, and that's good. Okay, so we are starting with, I like these, heavier weights. So this is a side curl, okay? This is a hammer curl. We're doing side hammers. So this is how your hands are pointed. So your palms are not fully facing forward, they're in a little angle. And this is a side hammer. It's a little awkward. So you can go heavy or medium. I might go mediums on these. Then we're doing it halfway. So it doesn't look like much of a movement, but you'll feel it. I think I'm dropping on that one. Then we're doing an in and out curl. So we come to the side, up. That's your in and out curl. Then we're ramping it up with a little cardio, a burpee squat or a catcher. We jump back, we bring it up here and say hi to the camera. If you are not doing, if you don't want the cardio and you're not doing that, or you can't get up and down without getting dizzy, I want you in a sumo squat, okay? It is a full minute, so try to keep it down. Try to pulse it out a bit to get a little bit more added extra. Lunge with a lift, we're grabbing our weights. You're doing one leg back, so you're coming down and lifting with the hammer curl. Okay, then we'll switch legs. Then, weight or no weight, we're going to do a curtsy, a squat, and a curtsy. Renegade planks, so we're down here. Growing up, that's a renegade plank. If you don't want to be down in the plank, you can do rows right here. Your next one is a chest press. So we're down on the floor. So I have the mat out for that. I'm not even gonna lay on that right now. Just to demonstrate, you can be here doing a chest press. You could be in a bridge. You could have feet up. All different ways of doing a chest press. And your last one, I believe, is a boat pose. Yes, so just be on the mat and holding a boat or a V-sit. There are your 10 moves, so you're only doing them once. I might be grabbing lighter ones. No shame in lightweights. So I will get our clock set, which I was supposed to do ahead of time. I suck today. 1 minute, 10 seconds in between, 10 moves, only doing it once.
Starting session.
So grab those heavy weights to start with. If you need to drop lower, drop lower. So hands are side hammers. Full minute. Once again, as I say every time, elbows glued into your sides. Full extension. And if you're feeling any pressure in your lower back, you bend those knees. You can stagger your stance. That sometimes helps people as well. As long as you're in a position that you're not feeling any tension in your lower back. We're almost there. We are really fatiguing the muscles today. All right, your next move is the same, except we're only coming halfway up. 30 seconds through, I'll change it to halfway the other way. So we're just starting bottom to mid. When we get to 30 seconds, we'll bring it up to our shoulders and come halfway down. Oh, these are rough. So it's a side hammer. Oof. Remember to breathe. In through your nose, out through your mouth. All right, bring them all the way up. Coming halfway down. You got this. We're doing in and out curls next. I told you, I warned you, it was going to be a tough one as far as strength here goes. All right. Your next move is an in and out curl. So it's a side curl. I'm pressing it up to a V. I'm not demonstrating because it hurts. Palms out. Side curl. Push it out and down. The good news is we're only doing everything one time. Get them up, push them out. You're almost there. You have 15 more seconds left. You have your cardio coming up next. We'll get those heart rates up. Put those weights down, get them out of the way. And you're doing burpee squats or catchers, whatever you'd like to call them. Or you are doing sumo squats. So down, back, bring it up wide, up. Chest is up, hands are up. You're feeling it right here. You're not standing all the way up. You are staying in a squat the entire time. You're opening up your hips. You're totally toning those inner thigh muscles, as well as your glutes. Remember, there's not a lot of cardio here. So, give one full minute of cardio where you can. Oh, that's a rough one. All right, lunge with a lift and a hammer curl. So grab those weights again. Right leg back. So you're coming down, You're lifting your legs, squeezing your butt, and doing a hammer. Does not need to be fast. You really want to feel the squeeze in your biceps and your butt at the same time. Oh, other side. Sorry. Wasn't paying enough attention there. Keep it up. There's your last one. All right. Curtsy, squat, curtsy. Was I supposed to do that on each side? I was skipping ahead. So we're only gonna do 9 instead of 10 because I screwed up there. Or maybe I'll throw something else in. It was supposed to be a full minute on each side and I went 30-30. Something else in. Trust me. Weight is not needed here. It's totally up to you. This is all upper and lower body. You're getting everything in today's workout. Planks. So we are down in a plank position doing rows. You can stand up and do rows if being down on the ground doesn't agree with you. So we're here. So in order for your body to not rock back and forth like this every time, this isn't what you want. Get those legs wider, gives you a more stable base of support, and your body doesn't move. There's nothing wrong with all of these little hacks to get your form correct. I can't see the timer. Oh, make sure your butt's not going up. And everything in line. All right. Chest press. Well, actually, before we get down there, since I have an extra one to do, we're going to squat and push it out since I screwed up the lunge lift. Then we'll get down on the ground for a chest press, followed by a boat pose. And your first round will be over. We're getting there, you're halfway through this one. Yeah, full minutes. They're no joke. Okay, we are down for chest presses. I should be doing this without having my butt up in the air at you guys. So let me try to come back here. You should already be going. You should be there. No wait for me. So I like to be in a bridge for this personally. You can be right down here. You do not need to utilize any additional muscles for this if you just want to focus on a chest press. Being in a bridge just adds in some glutes and abs and some quads. Because you're really concentrating here on not letting that butt droop. So you're tightening your core and getting some added ab work. Drop them. You can hold a weight in your belt pose if you would like. If you get bored, get them up. If you get bored here and you want to punch, you can punch it out. But the point of this is to just hold for 60 seconds. I love Gaga. Huge fan. I saw the Monster Tour 3 times. That's when I became a little monster. Ah, now you can't see my face. Oof. Oof. Yeah, I'm feeling it. It's good. Mind over matter. Try not to touch your legs like I keep doing. Oh, I want to see the time. There it is. Yay. All right. Great job. We have a whole new set of stuff to do. So let's get up. Grab a drink. You're done. Yeah. All right. So next, we're doing a military press, which is different than an overhead press. An overhead press, a lot of times, we kind of round it up. So military press, I'm going to do it this way with palms facing in. You're going straight up and down. Okay? Actually, let's do it this way. Total. No. This way. All right. You're just going straight up and down. You're not bringing it in. Sorry. That's a really bad, really bad cueing there. Kickbacks are here. Then we're doing rows. So if you did rows already, you do them again, working on that back. Unless you want to be on the floor doing chest flies. We're not doing those later, so. Burpees, again, that's going to be your cardio every time. With a push-up this time. If you're not doing burpees, you're not getting up and down, do regular push-ups or do push-ups on the wall. Or you can stand at the top of the burpee and do a squat with a little hop. Okay. Next is, this is where I got confused. I jumped ahead last time. Lunge with a knee lift. So we're going to reverse lunge and a knee lift. Let's do one weight. We'll alternate. We're going to knee lift, crunch, knee lift, crunch. Then we're going to cross jacks. A little more cardio. So we're crossing our arms. That's it. Lunge with a reach. So we lunge forward. Little stretch and back. Purpose of that is to work right here. You'll feel that stretch as you reach forward. Then we're going to a regular overhead press, as opposed to the military press, straight up and down. Then we come down for a bridge lift. Haven't decided if we're gonna hold or pulse yet. I'll let you know when we get there. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, yeah, we're good.
Starting session.
Sometimes I can't even. I just can't even. All right, get them up. So we're straight here, straight up and down. Remember to breathe. So I have such a memory tied to this song that I cannot share without totally embarrassing myself. But it has to do with an inside out shirt. And I know one of my friends who's watching this was with me the night of the inside out shirt. So if you're watching this, T, you'll remember that AC night with the inside out shirt. Oh, 3 more seconds. There's my line. Good times, good times. Kickbacks. I'm going to go a little lighter this time because I'm pretty sore already. Even though they're lighter, I'm not flying through them like this. That's not doing anything for you. You're squeezing those triceps at the top. Bring them in, squeeze. It's only 5 pounds for me, but it's doing the job. It's giving me good form here because they're not too heavy. I'm not swinging them. Rows are next, I'm gonna go back to heavy, but my triceps are feeling it right now, so. Like I said, you can drop lower when you need to. We're not here to injure ourselves. Rows are coming up. We're almost done with this one. 5 more seconds. All right. Rows. If you want to do rows on just one side first, I'll give you the signal for the halfway point. If you want a double row, that's fine. Just make sure you're squeezing that upper back. A single arm row is fine. You have 3 more seconds. If you want to switch arms, switch now. Only if you're doing singles. There's nothing to switch if you're doing doubles. Make sure that that core is sucked in and that tailbone's tucked under. Almost there, we go into our burpees with a push-up next. All right, drop them. Burpee with a push-up. You can just do the jumps at the top. If you don't want to get up and down, you can just do push-ups. And a push-up. Bring them in. You can jump. You can do wall push-ups. Make sure I wasn't jumping on a cat. Push-up. You can drop to your knees for the push-up. No shame. See, the more you add to the burpee, the less burpees you have to do. All right, we're more than halfway through. I'm dropping to my knees for my next one. And back up, feet in. You want those feet to land flat. You have 12 more seconds. You can get another one in. And jump. All right, not too much more cardio. Lunge with a knee lift and a little twist. Not lunge. Yes. We're gonna lunge, twist, alternating. Or you know what, keep it on one side. I'll just tell you when to switch. Didn't explain that the right way the first time. So we have legs and obliques here. And switch sides. That's the beauty of having a full minute. I can split things up this way. Perfectly even. cross jacks. Just crossing your arms, not your feet. It's a mental thing. You usually end up crossing both. If you're not jumping, you're here. Make sure you're breathing. You are now halfway through this. If you need to stop and do the modified version, do it. This is just to spike your heart rate a bit here, get you sweating. Here comes your countdown. You have 5 seconds. Okay, we are almost done with this. Lunge with a reach. We're doing each leg. So we're just going forward with the front leg. With the right leg. Reach. Bring it back. Same leg. Reach. Feel. It's such a hard one. I feel it, but you have to make sure, in order to feel it, that you are hinging forward. So when you're here, your whole body's coming forward and back. Switch legs. So you're here. This is the movement where you feel the stretch in your glute muscle. Ooh, balance. You have to practice this one a bit, because it's a slow move, but it's very effective. We were supposed to do one leg and then the other, but we're not now. Overhead press. I'm throwing something else in. Get them up. We'll do an extra ab. So you see the difference, right? From the military press to this. You're rotating your shoulders a little bit more. Ooh, you are at the halfway point. Shake. 10 seconds. All right, get them down. Okay, come down to the mat. We have two exercises. One is just going to be a bridge lift hold. I don't want to. You should be down already and up. Then I'll throw another one in. Squeeze that butt. You are in perfect alignment from shoulders to knees. One straight line. Breathing. You got this. I know it's boring. Just an ISO hold. You got it. All right, our last one is going to be jackknifes for a full minute. So you're here and coming up. I'll show you the modifications. Here's the modifications. One leg. If you can't get both legs up, you can just do one. This is not the move, okay? You need to get your upper body up. You can do one and one, and then a full jackknife. I like to do this when we have a lot of time, a full minute. You can bend those knees too. See, that's wrong. That's wrong. I'm being lazy. Get it up. Oh. Get up. Good job. We only have one more set left. Banging right through it. Guys, good job.
Stopping session.
Okay. Actually, we have two more, but the last one's just gliders. So now we're taking our lighter weights. And we're just doing front raises. Then we're just doing side raises. Then we're doing alternate raises. So I have fives. If you need to go lower, go lower. Then we're doing a burpee with a squat jump. So when you come to the top of your burpee, if you come up, really jump it up. You can also, if you're not doing the burpee, just give me squat jumps. If you're not doing cardio at all, squat, get those hands up overhead and up on your toes. What was next? Reverse lunge. We're just holding weights and doing, we're lunging on one side then the other. We're not alternating. Cross jacks with your feet this time. So if you can, try to get those feet crossed. Your modification is crossing over here. You want to feel the squeeze in your inner thighs. That's the purpose of that. Then we're doing push-ups. Just a minute of full-on push-ups. Then a tricep push-up with 10 mountain climbers. Another tricep, 10 mountain climbers, just in succession. If you don't want to be on the ground for mountain climbers, you can do standing mountain climbers the whole time. You can do a push-up on the wall and then do mountain climbers. And then our final move are bicycles. That's it. Are we ready?
Starting session.
We're getting our light weights now. I'm sticking with fives. I don't want to drop to twos. Okay. Get them up. Do not touch those legs. Bring it up. You hold that core in super tight. Make sure you are not touching those legs when you bring them back down. You're only going to shoulder height. And you're breathing. You're going to have super sexy summer arms for when we're allowed back outside. I shouldn't laugh. This is very serious. I already know people that have lost people close to them, and I know people in the hospital, people that are recovering out of the hospital now, so I'm not trying to make light of it. We're just all going a little stir crazy. All right, great. We're going out to the side now. Oh, that hurt. Just getting my arm up. Oh. Once again, it's going to be painful lifting that glass of wine to my lips tonight. I didn't have any wine last night. I should make up for it. Breathe. Once again, you are not hitting those, you're not touching the sides. Your legs at all. Try to keep your shoulders and your neck relaxed. No scrunching like this. You keep them down and relaxed. Breathe. We are alternating this lift next. So Your shoulders should be on fire. That 10 second break, shake it out. We're going alternating. Next. Okay, once again, not touching, you're just brushing by those legs. Your legs do not want what your hands have. 6 feet. All right, this hurts. Oh. Oof. No pain, no gain is for real. 20 more seconds. I know. Countdown's coming, I promise. Oh, burpees with a squat jump. Because your arms don't hurt enough to be doing the burpee. Ow, my God. All right, burpee, get it back. Pump it up. Squat jump. Back down. Squat jump. Again, you could just be here. If you're going super low impact and you're done with any cardio, this is your move. Get up on those toes. If you just don't want to get up and down, of course I'm doing all this because I don't feel like doing burpees. You are here because you want the cardio, but you don't want to get dizzy, or you don't feel on burpees. You have 15 more seconds. This is it. This is the last burpee of the day. Countdown's coming. 3, 2, 1. Okay, weights or no weights? You can have weights just not doing anything with them except adding the resistance. Just reverse lunge. You don't have to have the weights. It's up to you. I'm sore. I'm not doing the weights. You can keep the leg up if you want that added balance challenge. This is your active recovery after those burpees. Yes, we're just doing one leg. Then we'll do the other. You do not need to lift the knee. All right, we're switching to the other leg. And we're doing cross jacks with our feet. A little more cardio. If you do lift the knee, you get some added ab work. So this is my triple shot Tuesday. We started with cardio kickboxing this morning, moved into a boot camp in the afternoon, and now it's dinner time. I'm doing a little sculpting. And then I'm done for the day. I'm done with my pro bono job. We have 10 more seconds. All right, cross jacks with our feet. If you are not cross jacking, you're stepping it over. So you want to really cross it over and get that little squeeze in your upper thigh. The rest of us are doing this. Up on your toes. So get your hands nice and wide, actually outside of your mat, and bring it down. I need to double up my mat. My knees hurt. Again, nice and wide. That goes right across your lats. If your wrists start to hurt at all, you can always grab weights and hold on to those. My wrists were starting to hurt, that's why I said that. Keep it up. Child's pose. Your next move is a tricep push-up. 10 mountain climbers. Push-up mountain climbers. So you can do them on your knees. You should either have chaturanga arms for your push-up, or you could be in a diamond shape. That's working your triceps as well. And then once you're done with your push-up, you bring it up for 10 mountain climbers. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You could be standing up and doing mountain climbers the whole time. You could just do push-ups, tricep push-ups. You can do a push-up on the wall the whole time, or you could do that one followed by the mountain climbers. I don't care how you do it, as long as you're moving and working. Going. There's your break. Can you see what's next? So last one. Yes, on your back for bicycles. That's it. On your back. Get those legs moving. Get into those bicycles. Then we go into, I think it's 6 or 8 glider moves. And we're done. We will have another sculpting class on the books. Oh, where is those? Are those beeps? My form is getting super sloppy here. My legs are getting tired. Ugh. I know. That was a tough one. Let's get it back up. Ugh. All right. Session is complete. Okay. Gliders. So, if you have gliders or a towel, doing side lunges first. So one side, bring it in, Then we do the other. Then we're doing leg circles. So if you have a glider, so if you don't have a glider, you're just gonna do side lunges. Like that's pretty easy. So we're in a squatted position here and we're just circling. At 30 seconds, I'll have you reverse it, then we do the other leg. If you do not have gliders, you're going to be in a squat position, lifting your leg, okay, for a full minute. Sorry. We do both legs. I think that's it. I have a plank kick out. Nah, I did the reverse plank pull earlier. I don't want to do that again. So we'll just finish up with those last four moves, and then we'll be done. Let's see, four moves. Just a little added work at the end here. Let me just make sure. Music. I don't know how long we're into this class yet. All right, so grab a glider.
Starting session.
We're doing side lunges. So you're keeping it in close. First. And get it out. Full minute on each side. Again, you don't need the glider, you can just do side lunges. But this is so good for your inner thighs. Ooh. It hurts so good. There's something about the glider that really elongates that muscle. Oh! It just lets you go a little bit deeper into the move. All right. I do need to see my clock for another one, so. Ooh. Switching sides. So I think we targeted everything today. We got a lot of shoulder work in. We got a lot of biceps and triceps. Between those kickbacks and those push-ups, you got a little cardio, whole lot of legs, whole lot of booty, nice little mix of abs. So hopefully you enjoyed this as much as you can and squeeze it in. Ooh. We're almost there, 5 seconds. All right, so the squatted leg circles, this is where I need to tell you when you're halfway. If you are not, like I said, you're in a squat position and you're lifting. So the leg circles, go. You're going backwards. I will tell you when to reverse it. Like I said, you can be doing this on any kind of rag or towel, as long as it's small enough or folded up. And reverse directions. And if you are on a carpet, you might be able to do this with a plastic bag, as long as you're not pressing too hard into it, or a paper plate. If there's anything else that you've tried with it and it works for you, tell me so I have these ideas to put out there. I saw a workout the other day that somebody did with a frying pan. No lie. Ooh. They use the frying pan for like halos, all kinds of great stuff. Very creative. Everyone's just getting as creative as they can now. All right, we're going backwards first. I saw a workout, I posted this on Facebook. of things to do at home. And someone who's using a broom as like a body bar. That was pretty creative. And I have to say that I've been thinking about pulling out the broom or the Swifter. It's not a lot of weight, but all right, we're reversing it now. But he hung shoes on it, like tied sneakers, so they wouldn't fall off from the laces to get the added weight on there. So we might be getting really creative and do something like that that can totally steal from someone else. This is your last bit of work, guys. You have 10 more seconds and you're done. Here we go, 5 seconds. 3, 2, up. Good job. This is where I'd like to go around and high five everyone in the class, but nobody is touching anybody these days. It's all good. I'll get something a little slower on. We have You and I, Million Reasons Are Shallow. I can't hear what you're yelling to me, so I'm going to go with Shallow. Just because. I do love You and I, though. But this one just really gets me as well. Love some Gaga. So much. All right. How's everyone feeling? Good? Happy it's over? All right. Get those hands on the hips. Oh. We're going to kind of start off or finish how we started. We did a lot of inner thigh work, so we want to get that all stretched out. Let's go over to a side lunge. Let's turn it around to a runner's lunge. Take this hand, put it on the inside of your foot, and twist up. Now, let's stretch it out in the middle. Little movement here is fine. And stretch it out, the side lunge again. I should feel great on your inner thighs. Let's turn it around to a runner's lunge. Place that hand down, twist the opposite arm up. Back to that wide straddle. Hands flat on the floor. Lift those toes up, stretch out the backs of those legs. So many squats and lunges today. And down. Try to keep those hands flat as you bring those feet in. Of course, come up to fingertips. And roll it up. Let's take an arm, stretch it out here. You are stretching from your wrist all the way up. Through your biceps. Other side. And cross it over. And grab a tricep. Keep breathing. Other side. Done. thank you once again. Here's you and I love this song. Thank you once again for tuning in, and I hope that the sculpting class was good for you. I know a lot of you don't want to do all cardio, so I like to throw these classes in to give you a little bit of variety. Again, I'm open for suggestions. You know, throw out classes you'd like to see other than yoga or Zumba, because neither of which I have any certifications in, and I'm not very good at either. A little yoga, but nothing that I'm able to really teach. So there's bar. I will get some bar classes in. I keep saying that. There's Tabata that I'll definitely be throwing in. There's some HIIT classes. So if there's anything in particular, you know where to find me. Have a great rest of your night. Enjoy your wine, your beer, whatever it is that you're partaking in this evening, or just a nice healthy dinner. So have a great night, and I will see you again tomorrow. Bye.